Eaton Hall. And this pandemic has made us go back 20, 30 years, and we think to ourselves, no, no, let this pandemic finish and we'll get on our feet again. And no, no, time will not wait for us. We need to make the preparations all the time, whether there's a pandemic or not. There's two types of people, optimistic and pessimistic, positive thinker, negative thinker. Optimistic person, he takes out opportunities from difficulties. And a pessimistic person, negative thinker, he takes out difficulty from opportunities. I hope you understand this. Do you know there was this shoe manufacturer, they were manufacturing shoes and they wanted to send their reps towards the aborigines. So basically what happened, they sent two reps, and after some time the telegram came. So one of them, he said, there is no opportunities here, they don't wear shoes. And the one who was positive, he said, there's great opportunities here, they don't wear shoes. I hope you understood this. Being optimistic and being pessimistic. So we have to be positive thinker. We can't just be thinking to ourselves, no, it's going to get better. No, it's never going to get better. And this is proven from the hadith where he mentions in Kitab al-Fitan, Imam Bukhari rahmatullah mentions a beautiful hadith. Zubair ibn Adi rahimahullah ta'ala says, Atayna Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. We came in the presence of Anas ibn Malik. And who was Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu ta'ala anhu? Amazing. He was the khadim, the servant of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who stayed in his company for 10 years. He did his khidmat. So, amazing person. So, he was a prominent companion. So they came and he said, فَشَكَوْنَا إِلَيْهِ مَا نَلْقَى مِنَ الْحَجَّاجِ. We complained to Anas ibn Malik regarding the atrocities and the disaster and the calamities and the tyranny and the oppression and the injustice which was meted by Hajjaj, who was called Zalimu Hazil Ummah, who was a tyrant of this Ummah. He was the governor of Iraq and he was this notorious killer. He murdered, assassinated the likes of Sayyidina Zubair, Abdullah bin Zubair, the likes of Sa'id ibn Jubair. So people were complaining, what is he doing? He's killing all the Sahaba Ikram, all the Tabi'een. He was so notorious, so evil. So what did Anas ibn Malik radiallahu ta'ala say? Isbiru hatta talqaw rabbakum. Be patient until you meet your Lord. فَإِنَّهُ لَا يَأْتِي عَلَيْكُمْ زَمَانٌ إِلَّا الَّذِي بَعْدَهُ شَرٌّ مِّنْهُ سَمِعْتُهُ مِنْ نَبِيِّكُمْ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. That each day as it comes, it's going to be worse than before. So basically, the future will not be better than now. Each day as it comes, it's going to get worse. So if we're going to be waiting, let the pandemic finish, then I'm going to come to the masjid. No, it's not going to happen, my brother, my sister. We need to start now. We have to be optimistic. We need to move on. We have to be active. Like in the English saying goes, between the regret of yesterday and the hope of tomorrow is the opportunity of today. I hope you understand this. All these regrets, oh no, we didn't read namaz, the pandemic stopped us from coming to the masjid. We need to reconnect with the masjid again. So the regret, do tawbah, sincere tawbah, atta ibn al-zambi kamal la zambala, do the tawbah and start. And don't have this kind of thing, you know, okay, the hope, I'll do it tomorrow. Iyaka wa taswif, Hasan al-Basri rahmatullah alayhi says, save yourself from procrastination. I'll do it tomorrow. Tomorrow never comes. So this is, we need to move forward. And we need to make sure we prepare for the hereafter. What do Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu say? Hasibu anfusakum qabla an tuhasabu. Do your accounts before your accounts are done. Wazinu qabla an tuzanu. Do your wazan. Not your physical weight, nor do the wazan of your deeds. Ta'ahabu lil ardil akbari ala man la tukhfa alayhi a'malukum. Be prepared for that big presentation in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, upon whom nothing will be hidden.